Hello and welcome to the special edition of Market Guru. Joining me today is Sunil Singhania of Reliance Mutual Fund. Thanks very much, Sunil. It's always a pleasure talking to you. My first question, what are we really going through? We've seen, at least in the last 10 days, such severe bouts of volatility, 500 points up, pullback, down. What is causing this?
I think, you know, Vivek, if you see what the market has been witnessing specifically over the last 2-3 months, and that is a global phenomena, is a massive sort of surge of liquidity in the system coming obviously from what US has done and what Japan has also announced, and what we at least feel that even EU will go through. So I think this huge surge in liquidity was basically the reason why, you know, global equities were bought massively. And over the last few days, there's always been this concern of how this is going to end in near term, whether there's going to be some tightening of liquidity and so on and so forth. So these bouts of markets moving up and down are largely a reflection of the news flow which is emanating, pertaining to obviously the flows.
We had no less than our finance minister coming out and clarifying and saying that, you know, stop reacting to this, that's not what he meant. Is somewhere the market picking up every word a little too closely according to you?
See, that this is the advent of modern times, modern communication. You know, everyone knows the same thing at the same time and wants to react in the same direction again at the same time. And that is the reason you have massive moves both on the upside and the downside. And I think we have to be prepared to witness more of this as we move forward.
I remember when we last spoke, and even prior to that, Sunil, of course, it was a little while ago. It was in October. And I remember on at least 2 or 3 occasions you mentioned during that interview that the fact that the rupee had stabilized, the currency had stabilized, was something which was a good news. We've recently seen, again, weakness coming in into the rupee this month, over 5% right. Down. Is that something which is spooking the markets?
See, frankly, our own view was that rupee should stabilize between 54 to 56. And pretty much it was doing right. Or moving in that fashion till, as you said, 10, 15 days back. So obviously this, decisive move over 56 has definitely been a cause of worry. Though we can say that it has been largely due to US dollar being very strong. And, you know, rupee also has not depreciated to that extent against the other currencies. But still, you know, anything over 56 definitely causes a little bit of concern. I think what typically is also happening is that, because of this gold price fall, there was a massive surge of gold imports in April and May. And traditionally also, May is a period where oil marketing companies tend to have a higher demand for dollars because they've got their subsidy bill cleared or at least announced, and they, you know, also have this massive inflow. So traditionally also May has been one month where the demand for dollars shoots up. But having said that, I think a decisive move over 56 has definitely caused some degree of concern in the market, and probably some uncertainty which you are viewing in this market might also be a reflection of that.
How concerned are you about the current account deficit?
See, from our perspective, obviously last year, financial year 13, if you see, current account deficit plus fiscal deficit plus inflation was almost 20%, and which is a scary number. This year, we feel that all the three put together would be somewhere in the region of 13%, which is a big sort of, positive. So whether fiscal deficit comes at 5% or current account deficit falls to around 4% and inflation falls to 4-5%, I think we are seeing a number which is falling from 20% to 13%. And I think that's a very, very big positive incrementally. Obviously, current account deficit at 5% is scary, but probably we have hit the peak. God willing, and the way the commodity markets are moving, and hopefully the insatiable appetite for gold from Indians will also subside a little bit, we might see current account deficit falling decisively below 4%.
What is scary is you saying God willing.
We are not experts on commodities. And that is the reason.
But I'm saying somebody recently said, one of your old colleagues said, God is an Indian. That if the commodity prices hadn't fallen the way they did, we probably would have been in a very bad shape.
But that will always be the case. You know, if commodities would not have fallen, something else positive would have happened. You never know. But if you see the global markets, I think for the first time in so many years, we are seeing commodity prices soft despite this huge surge in liquidity, which clearly points to the fact that, you know, fundamentally commodities are weak. China is slowing down. There are alternative finds of oil. We are, in fact, reading in various global media that in Africa, at least, the demand for export of crude has fallen quite significantly because U.S., which was a big importer of crude from these nations, has suddenly reduced its imports quite substantially. U.S., obviously, shale gas story is known. Russia is going ahead. China is going ahead massively in their quest for finding shale oil. So I think fundamentally, definitely, there seems to be a case of a softness continuing in the commodity prices, and which should be good. So, India, frankly, is in a best position. We have huge surge in liquidity, and we need those dollars. And we have soft commodity prices, and we are basically, the biggest importer among all the BRIC countries as far as commodities are concerned.
What worries you the most? The fact that even if a small amount of these inflows turns around, given the fact that our mutual fund industry is still struggling to get inflows, our insurance industry is still struggling, such an FII-dominated market. When I posed this question to the RBI governor, he said there's a reasonable probability of an impending outflow. Is that something that could be the big shocker, that even if a small amount of this turns around and goes back, we could be looking at far lower levels?
If that happens, obviously, there will be some cause of concern, but we don't have that view. Frankly, our view is that FII plus FDI plus all this multinational companies increasing their stake in India, they will continue to hit new records. And we are seeing it, one company coming out and doing a buyback of $5 billion. Many more would like to do that. I think it's only a waiting game. This huge global liquidity and very, very soft interest rates obviously are incentivizing a lot of these companies to even go further and be a little bit more aggressively. So even if you go ahead and buy or, buy your own share, let's say 50p, and if you're getting money at 0.5%, you still are, causing earnings to be accretive. So our view is that in some form, inflows will continue. It is possible that in the near term, they might slow down or turn negative. We don't know about that. But if you see on an annual basis, our view would be that, inflows should be quite strong.
Again, going back to when we last spoke, and most market gurus like you at that time were of the view, and I'm talking now about earnings, Sunil, that the worst is over. But 6 months later, I still hear the worst is over.
No, I think if you read the transcript properly, we had said that March would be probably the last quarter where earnings would tend to disappoint. In fact, if you see the overall earnings, there are lesser number of companies which disappointed this March than there ever in the last four quarters. Yeah. Yes, there have been few large companies which have disappointed, but there have been equally or probably more number of companies who have, positively surprised. So our view would be that with a falling commodity price environment and with a falling interest rate environment, at least on the bottom line, things should start to improve on June. I think what is still not clear is whether the top line growth will start to inch up. And frankly, we don't see that happening immediately. But hopefully in the next 2-3 quarters, we will start to see that also.
So 2-3 quarters top line, but from the next quarter, you expect bottom line certainly to start looking.
Right.
And that's been largely due to what? Cost cutting, isn't it? So the system's not expanding. The businesses are not expanding. The capex cycle is still where it was.
Right. One is efficiency because of the stressful sort of period which companies have gone through. There's been no incremental capex, so there's no incremental depreciation and interest. Interest costs are incrementally coming down. And commodities has been the biggest sort of contributor to this, at least increase in the EBITDA margins, which actually, if you see, a lot of companies in this quarter also have started to reflect the benefit. So whether it's some steel companies, whether it's some auto companies, even some engineering companies, the top line might not have grown as much, but on the EBITDA front, there have been a decent amount of surprises.